Jay Sands. Sands on sports, hip-hop, and sports entertainment at its finest. That's right, y'all. The big kid is at it again. So let's jump into it, starting off with PGA Golf. And everybody heard about it. Tiger Woods got caught up. But yo, let me put to you like this. Men don't gossip. So therefore, only got two things to say about it. He's the best player in PGA right now, and after his career, he'll probably be the best who ever did it. So, let's move right along to the NFL Week 13, starting with the Tennessee Titans 5-6 at the Indianapolis Colts 11-0. Now, Tennessee, they must run the ball. Simple and plain. Keep the Peyton Manning off the field. Keep the ball out of his hand, because if he don't, he's going to be throwing bombs to Wayne, and Garcon, and all the other receivers, Dallas Clark. So, keep Peyton Manning off the field. Also, Dwight Freeney is back for the Colts. When Freeney's on that defense, they're pretty good. So, yeah, we'll look out for the Colts to basically take that step. But also, big up to Vince Young. He's going to make some plays, definitely. The next game I'm going to go into is the Dallas Cowboys 8-3 at the New York Giants 6-5. Now, the Giants, they give up 100-plus yards, 4.2 yards per carry every game. And that's horrible. You can't have somebody getting 100 on you every damn game. So the Giants got to step up on the defense side. And this is the season for Tony Romo's play to go from here to there. He's done it in the past season. He's probably going to do it this December. But still, I got the Cowboys winning this game. Now let's go to the Minnesota Vikings 10-1 at the Arizona Cardinals 7-4. Now, this is what that Minnesota needs to do, because everybody's stacking the line against Adrian Peterson. Let Brett Favre throw it on first down, then hand it off to AP on second and third, you know what I'm saying? Also, Kurt Warner, he didn't play last week. Matt Leinart came in the game. They lost, but he did a pretty good job. 21 for 31 passing, and he threw for 220 yards. But hey, we'll have to see. I think the Vikings are going to move on with the victory. Now let's move on to the Baltimore Ravens, 6-5 at the Green Bay Packers, 7-4. Now let's put you like this. The Packers offense with Aaron Rodgers can be very explosive at times. And what at times means is that sometimes it's not. So if it's hot, I look for Green Bay to do major things in this game. Now what Baltimore wants to do is they have three running backs, McGahee, Rice, and McClain. They need to run, baby, run. Make this game the most boring game ever in the NFL, and that's how to go to victory. Now let's go to the Bowl of the Week. And I got Tampa Bay Buccaneers at 1-10 at the Carolina Panthers 4-7. Now, Carolina, you know, they got the two running backs, and Tampa Bay knows they're going to run the ball, run the ball, run the ball. Can Tampa Bay stop it? That remains to be seen. Also, the Buccaneers have not had a running back go over 100 yards in 21 games, and that's horrible. If you don't have a running game, you do not win in the NFL. But, yo, you know how I do on Sands on Sports. Always have the hot guest. This week, I got my man from the West Side. That's right, Superfly. He's on the show. This is Jay Sands, Sands on Sports, and I'll be back. Peace. All right, what's up, y'all? It's your man, Jay Sands, Sands on Sports. Got special guest, my man, Superfly from the West Side. You know how we do, man.
What's up with you, man? I'm just doing it big, man.
Thank you very much for being on the show. We're going to be real quick about it, fam. What's up? Y'all just got older, man. What's that mean for L.A., man?
That mean we finna go get another ring. That's what that means.
That don't take a long answer for that.
Oh. That mean it don't matter what y'all doing over there trying to build and stack up your team, the champion is coming to get another one.
Oh, okay, yeah. Okay. Kobe want three of them. If you want to be serious, you want to get three back-to-back, you know what I'm saying? But we're going to work on that when it comes. But we got Odom back. We got a nice addition with Ron Artest.
Okay. We looking good,
hey,
man.
So I tell you, you're a Lakers fan.
I'm a diehard Lakers fan.
Okay.
Yeah, I love the Lakers, man.
And that's it. Baseball, like the Dodgers?
I ain't a baseball fan, okay, but of course, I got to go with my Dodgers.
Manny
Wood. Yeah, Manny Wood. I love personally any minority that's making it in the big time, you know, sports or whatever. Getting it.
Check it out. Y'all don't got a football team. So who do you like in football? You a Raiders up top?
Raiders fan.
You like Raiders? Okay, black. Okay.
Not hard Raiders.
What's up with man Russell? DeMarcus, what he going through this year?
Man, the Raiders ain't going to really do too much until Al Davis kind of.
Okay, like, you see when that Al got to step down.
He got to make, because the whole program's got to change.
Okay. Superfly giving you the deals on this.
Everybody know that. I love my Raiders, but I don't see nothing happening with y'all for a while. You know what I'm saying? But y'all know the answer, man. Gotta get rid of Al. Yeah. Y'all from the top again. Yeah, man. You gotta come through, man. That's the old way. That's 2009 right now.
And let me ask you this, what sports you play coming up? You know, out in LA, what sports you play?
Football and basketball.
Man,
like
you coach. Tell me about the team that you coach.
Yeah, I coach in the Snoopy Football League. I got the 7 9-year-olds, first year tackle, you know what I mean? And we go hard, you know what I mean? Bottom line, I take the we all take the underprivileged kids, you know, that really can't afford, you know, paying $200, $300 for a football season. Charge them $100, you come out and play with them, you know what I mean? At the same time, we teach them how to stay out of the streets and how to deal with things in the streets that I know that we can't stop, you know, from happening to you. You know what I mean? We know things happen to the young niggas, so we just try to give you the best way and show you discipline in playing football.
Hey, yo, you football's big, you know what I'm saying? I'm from Pittsburgh, big in Pittsburgh, too. Big up to my man Superfly for coming on Sands on Sports. Now we're going to the email question of the week from my man AC in LA. He says, yo, Jay Sands, have you ever had drinks while playing sports like your man Ron Artest? If you don't know, Ron Artest admitted last week that he was drinking Hennessy during the halftime when he was playing with the Chicago Bulls. Well, if you're an athlete like Jay Sands, then you know a little bit about, you know, drinking and whatnot, because I played the Turkey Bowl on the north side of the Northview Heights. We drank a Thunderbird and Wild Irish Rose MD before we played the Thanksgiving Turkey Bowl. And also, if you're a hooper, you know that dude that comes to the hoop court with the jeans on, the work boots, smelling like a fifth of Bacardi that lights you up for about 30. So there's nothing wrong with drinking while getting it in on the athletic field. But when you get paid for it, I don't know. But Ron tested that dude, so I'm rolling with Ronnie. Now let's go into Who's Hot. And I gotta give it up to my man, Sidney King Crosby of the Pittsburgh Penguins. That's right, y'all. Sidney Crosby has 11 points in the last 3 games. So Sidney King, you're hot, baby. Now let's go into the pick of the week. And I got my Cincinnati Bearcats 11-0 at the Pitt Panthers 7-4. Now this will be a close game, or it will start out to be a close game. But I think the Bearcats will spread out the Panthers' defense, and that will tire them out, and the Bearcats are basically going for a victory. So I'm picking UC, y'all, to go undefeated. Now, I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to get a shout out to my man AI. He's back in the league, baby. Allen Iverson, Philadelphia. And if you like your man AI, like I like AI, you know he's a real good look. But yo, this is Jay Sands. This is Sands on Sports, and I'm out of here.